Hey everybody, welcome to Mondays with Michelle at OutLateButGreat. This week's topic was set by Jim, and it is as follows. As a lesbian, gay, bisexual, or transgendered person, what are some examples of discrimination, judgment, and intolerance that you have experienced from people you know? And how did you manage to overcome that and change the hearts and minds of those people so that they now accept and embrace who you are? Well, I thought I was going to come on here this week and say, well, so far I haven't experienced anything like that, and so there's my topic and have a nice week. But something happened recently that gave me something to talk about. And I was kind of apprehensive about talking about this subject because it has to do with work. And I was going to tell it as if it were happening to Sally. You remember Sally from a couple videos of mine ago? But it was something that I really felt I needed to talk about. And so Sally's not going to be here this week. A couple weeks ago, I was at work. And without going into too much detail about where I work, I will just say that I sing for a very large religious institution who belongs to a religion in general that is not against gays and lesbians and transgendered people, because they have a bishop that is gay and they now recently have a lesbian that is also a bishop in LA. And so just by saying that, you might know what I'm talking about. But I'm trying to keep it as generic as I can for my own protection. There seems to be an issue with some of the churches of this denomination because they are furious and intolerant of there being gay bishops in their religion. And so a lot of these people would really love to be able to not identify with the same religion that has these bishops. So there was a big brouhaha, I suppose, because I'm not the religion that I work for. And I work for a couple different religious institutions as a singer. So I'm not the religion of either one, actually. And so a lot of the congregants decided that they did not want to give money to the church anymore, because the church has to then give part of that money to the national church. The national church, which is headed by a woman, actually, has these gay bishops in New Hampshire and in LA. So this particular church that I work for decided that it was going to be okay now for the people to not have to give their money to the national church, but that they could write on their check that they wanted it to stay local. And so that was decided. Fine. Okay, I don't really have as much of an issue with that, but it's what I'm getting ready to tell you that really was frightening. 2 weeks ago, the person in charge had to announce this at the service in the morning, both services. And so, you know, he was being really very diplomatic about it and said, so now you can write on your check if you want the, you know, money to not go to the national church, it doesn't have to go there. And all of a sudden the congregation started clapping and yelling, yeah, and, you know, like cheering. And it just hit me that these people were cheering against me, essentially. And I could feel my body temperature going up. I could feel that, you know, kind of blood boiling, upsettedness that you get, and it was just rising, and I just tried to sit there and breathe. And it just, like, it was so surreal, you know. I almost can't even describe how I felt because it was so unnerving. I couldn't decide whether I was in the middle of a Stepford Wives movie or if I was attending Joan of Arc's execution. So it really upset me. And thankfully, my direct boss, she knows that I'm gay. She's totally supportive of me. I mean, and most of the people that I work with who sing with me, I mean, almost without exception, I think, are totally accepting and are very cool with it. And in fact, there's a lot of people that do not agree with the, you know, trend, let's just say. Then something occurred to me. Okay. A few things occurred to me, actually. While these people were hooting and hollering, they had no idea that maybe in the congregation next to them was someone who was gay. Maybe someone in the congregation next to them has a gay son or a transgender daughter. Or maybe someone that sings for them every week and has so for 12 years is a lesbian. And if they keep their money local, they're paying my check. And, you can do the math from there. So I managed to, in the space of 5 minutes, be able to bring my emotions under control. And also by talking to a few other people after the service, and they were like, you know, just let it roll off. But it was really quite emotional, and I didn't think I was going to be able to make this video without crying, because when I first came home and told Kirsten what had happened, I was in tears, because it really hurt. It really, really hurt. Because there's a lot of people in that congregation that do not know that I'm gay. And they're as sweet and polite and nice to me as can be. But would they be if they knew? I don't know. So, the way that I plan to deal with this and just maybe change the hearts and minds someday is I'm going to keep on being polite and kind and try to be compassionate, because these people are just coming from a place of intense programming or their upbringing or whatever. And I'm just going to try and just be the best person that I can be still, you know? Because one day they may find out through the grapevine or whatever, you know? I don't know. So that's my plan. So anyway, there you go. I know this video is a little heavy this week, and I didn't have all my cute editing and graphics and stuff like that, but this was something that I really wanted to talk about, and thank you, Jim, because your topic really gave me the outlet in which to talk about this, and I was pretty apprehensive about it at first. So now it's out there, but it's the truth of what happened, and it's the truth of how it made me feel, and, you know, that's just what it is. It is what it is, right? So anyway, if you've gotten this far and I haven't completely depressed you, thank you so much for watching and for how supportive you all are being. And I'll ask again, if you think of any topics, please email one of us or send a note to the channel or comment and let us know what you'd like to hear us talk about, because this channel is for all of us. Okay, everybody, make it a great week.